डियर स्टूडेंट, इट्स थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर फर्स्ट, द बेस्ट क्रिसमस प्रेजेंट इन द वर्ल्ड। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द थर्ड पार्ट, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड पार्ट। आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड द सेकेंड पार्ट, बट वी रिवाइज द शॉर्ट समरी ऑफ सेकेंड पार्ट। इन सेकेंड पार्ट, एंटायरली अ डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ अ लेटर विच वॉज रिटन बाय जिम मैकपर्सन टू हिज वाइफ Connie. Jim McPherson mentioned in the letter how they celebrated Christmas with German soldiers, means with their enemies, how they played football, how they shared eatables with each other, and even he met with German officer Mr. Hans Wolf. So in third part, we will read about how the author handed over that letter to its rightful owner, Mrs. Connie. So in third paragraph first, having read the letter, the author put it back in the envelope. He decided to give the letter back to whom it belonged. It belong means to Mrs. Connie. The address was of Bridport, Dorset. So he drove to that place. The house number 12 turned out to be a burnout shell. When he reached there, so as per the address, that house was completely burned out. It was found that Mrs. McPherson was in the house when it caught fire. Then the author decided to ask about Connie to other people. So he asked a lovely old lady, and she told him Mrs. Connie always used the candles because the electricity was very expensive for her. So due to that candle, the house got fire. The fireman had got her out just in time, and she was 101 year old now. She was in a nursing home. So the part third paragraph first finish. So I hope you understood the explanation of part third paragraph first. So comprehension question, which was based upon this part: why did the author go to Bridport? Answer: the author went to Bridport to meet Mrs. Connie McPherson and deliver to her Jim's letter. Question second: how old was Mrs. McPherson now? Where was she? Answer: Mrs. McPherson was 101 year old. She was in a nursing home. Now, chapter part third, paragraph second. The author went to the nursing home. The nursing home was situated in Burlington. He met the matron. She told the author that Mrs. McPherson was rather confused that day. They had put her in a conservatory room. The author found Mrs. McPherson sitting in a chair. Naturally, she looked up at the author's vacantly. When author reached there, she looked at him without any expression or without any words, but her eyes lit up when he called her Connie and gave her the letter. He told her how he had got the letter, but she was not listening to him. The author tried to explain all the things, how this letter reached to him, and he read it, and how he got the address of this nursing home, but she was not given a single expression to him. Just like that, she was not listening anything. She reached out and took his hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. She felt that her Jim had returned. She understood that that writer was Jim McPherson. He had returned on the eve of Christmas. She made him sit beside her. She kissed her cheek. She talked long and lovingly to him. She said that she had got the best Christmas present in the world. So this way, this part third finish, and I hope you understood this third part explanation. Now comprehension questions based upon this third part. Who did Connie McPherson think her visitor was? So Connie thought that the visitor was her own husband, Jim McPherson. Question second, which sentence in the text show that the visitor did not try to hide his identity? Answer, the sentence is, you told me you'd come home by Christmas, dearest. She said, and here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim, dear, sit down. So, moral of the story, the story Best Christmas Present in the World has beautifully depicted the moral lesson. It conveys that war and fight only bring sadness and humiliation all around the world. One should generally follow the path of peace for attaining happiness in the world. Now, the working with the text part. In working with the text, the question first. For how long do you think Connie had kept Jim's letter? Give reason for your answer. Answer, Connie had kept Jim's letter for a long time. She had received it on January 25, 1915. Jim had written it on December 26, 1914. At that time, Jim was a captain in the English army. A captain in the army is always a young man. It means that Jim's wife Connie must have also been young. In the story, she is 101 years old. It means the letter was about 70 to 75 years old. Question second, why do you think the desk had been sold and when? Answer, the desk must have been sold when Connie's house had burned. The table had been damaged by fire as well as water. Question third, why do Jim and Hans think that games or sports are good ways of resolving conflicts? Do you agree? Answer, both Jim and Hans were soldiers. Both were full of human kindness. They had seen the sufferings of war, so it was natural for them to hate war. They favored a peaceful solution to settle disputes. They said that games or sports were a good way of resolving conflicts. I also quite agree with them. Question fourth, do you think the soldiers of the two armies are like each other or different from each other? Find evidence from the story to support your answers. Answer, all human beings are alike in many ways. They love peace and hate war. They want to live together. Examples from the story. Then they were calling out to us from across no man's land. Happy Christmas, Tommy. Happy Christmas. Question fifth. Mention the various ways in which the British and the German soldiers become friends and find things in common at Christmas. The British and the German soldiers belong to different camps. They were enemies in wartime. But after all, they were human beings and therefore they had similar feelings. They shared the festive spirit of the Christmas. They got over hatred and played games, rested and drank like good friends. Both hated war. Both were anxious to go back to their families at the end of war. Question 6. What is Connie's Christmas present? Why is it the best Christmas present in the world? Answer. When the narrator came to see Connie and gave her the box, she mistook him for her husband Jim. She thought that Jim had kept his promise and come home for Christmas. This was Connie's Christmas present. It was the best Christmas present in the world for her, because Jim had written in the letter that he would come home on Christmas. She had read that letter several times every day to feel that he was near her and truly believed that he would one day return to her. Now that he was finally there with her, and she was extremely happy. Question 7. Do you think the title of the story is suitable for it? Can you think of any other titles? Answer. The title of the story is most suitable. For the old Connie, no other present could have given her such joy as the coming home of Jim, her husband. Her presumptions might be wrong, but she got the greatest happiness of her life. Since the story revolves around Christmas, the alternate title of the story could be War and Peace or Christmas Gift, but neither can be matched to the present title. Thank you so much, student. I hope you understood all the three parts of this story. Thank you so much.